Hello and welcome to another episode of Speed. Short, powerful episodes of enthusiasm and determination. What a marvelous life we have, don't we? All of us. I mean, seriously. I've said it before, if you're watching this, then you have the technology to see it. If you're listening to it in your car, you have the technology to hear it on a podcast. It's incredible what we take for granted. You know, we moan about stuff, well, we haven't got this, or we haven't got that, or this person's got that. But look at our life. Look at our life. It's incredible. It's amazing. Now, if you're looking to make some decisions and look forward into the future about where life's going to go technology-wise or opportunity-wise or business-wise or wherever you're going, the people who've had the vision or the word or whatever they've had have done it before it was necessary, haven't they? Think about that. Now, Noah, we all know that Noah built an ark. You might not believe that. That's okay. It doesn't matter what you believe in this instance. But we do know that in the story, Noah built the ark before it started raining. What? I know. So he started building the ark before it rained, not while it was raining. Jeff Bezos is one of the richest people on this planet. He started Amazon.com. before online shopping was beyond even a concept. And he lost so much money for so many years, it is actually surprising he made it through. But he had a vision. He had a vision that online shopping would become a reality and would become mainstream. He built an online shopping platform before online shopping platforms were being built. And everybody thought he was crazy, except some people who invested in him on a continuous basis. And he certainly didn't think he was crazy. And right now, you don't think he's crazy either. Because he took that step. He looked to his future. Now, I'm not saying you go and build an ark or build an online shopping site. But look at what you're doing with your life right now and think what you might be doing in 10 years' time, 20 years' time, what you'd love to be doing in 10 years' time or 20 years' time. You might be wanting to secure your future for your family, for example. Maybe you're not good at technology. You could certainly learn the next 10 years, couldn't you? Part-time, offline, polytech, something like that. You could learn, couldn't you? You could learn in a year, 2 years, couldn't you? What else are you doing in your evening? Watching TV, maybe? Playing games? Don't know. Put it into your future. You might get some ideas. You might start going to some classes. You might start reading some different books, changing, thinking, what's going on with the world? Where's it going? Where am I going to be? Where are my children going to be? Where are my grandchildren going to be? You might become a person who's the new Jeff Bezos or the new Steve Jobs. Don't know. You might even build an ark. It's good to get these things done before it starts raining. Think ahead. Change yourself. Keep moving. Don't get caught in the past. It's already gone. That's why it's called the past, funnily enough. You can do it. You know you can do it. Thanks for listening. I really appreciate it. Have a fabulous day. Bye-bye.